great. It sounds great. Premises. Put it away. I see the lens cap. It is dangling. Come on, if you point it that way, we're going to be in Guantanamo Bay. That's like the ghost of the security lady. Put it away! Okay, you can keep it on. Oh, you can keep it on. Yes. We're making my movie here. So you need a new project. One with cyborgs and guns. Oh, you know exactly what you need? Remember that kid you went and filmed the other day? I was like, film cat. And you're just like, no, he was wearing the hat. Perfect for like an action sequence. Have him do anything. Like rush into somebody. You need movement. You can't just have people talking to camera all the time. You need action. And we're gonna go where the action is. Let's go, vacation, right on the river. We'll get there, we'll go from there. We'll go up and down the goddamn Silk Road. Even the Oregon Trail, anything. Berkeley. look, they're dust. They're spraying for the apple moths that we brought over from New Zealand. The Lely brought apple moth. They're gonna have to spray us here in Oakland the way they've been spraying in Berkeley. Well, they're killing our moths.
Who speaks for the apple moth?
Is it because they're white brown?
No one.
They're not white. Mosquitoes.
Apple moths are people
they're white
too.
Brown apple we need them. But you know what it does? It cuts profits.
I hate fucking apples. You know what I hate? You know what
they're dangerous to our food supply.
Fucking apples.
Oh, she told me, my coach just told me I can eat apples if I cook them.
Only if we serve them with moth.
Cooked apple moths. We're feeding on our own kind. What are we, cannibals? We're eating our moth children. Reminds me of Silence of the Land.
No, dude, that was moths. Urkel.
Did I do that?
Did I eat my own? Did I kill my children?
So, how long before the next poo? When's the next poo coming out?
Cut. But in the meantime, what are we gonna do? How are we gonna blow these popsicle stands? There's no other popsicle stand to go to. Ever heard Shell Beach? I know you make two lefts and a right. You know, like, there's how do you get out of Berkeley? How do you get out of Berkeley? Oh, it's easy. You just go. Well, I've done this before. Me and the wife, we get out of Berkeley all the time. You just go. Go down. Hold on. I got this. To get out of Berkeley, you go. All right, quit joking around here. How do we get out of Berkeley?
Making a new movie. Oh shit. The place is a mess. It's not a good idea.
Are you up to movie number 3 now?
Slow pan.
And here I am reprising my role in movie number 1. My big fat homeless Berkeley movie. Starring me, guest starring me, co-starring me, and me by special appearance. And here I am reprising my role. Tell me again about my eyes.
How many can I get you, sir?
Johnny.
Later, Johnny, man.
You brought out some of your old archival footage?
Yeah, right.
Is that your real name? What is your real name?
He has another name.
Yeah.
Okay, but here's my name. Okay, I'm introducing my... lunatic friend here to Mr. Bernard Shaw.
That's good.
Okay, do it.
A penny for luck. I think
that's it. Get in there, dude. Tell the world what it needs to know.
Well, we can't say it hasn't been fun. That's the bottom line. What do you think?
I think the magic bullet is yet to be found, but if someone were to ask me, I'd say, this man here is a magician. I'm the physician.
I want to make it with you.
Uh-oh.
I want to make it with you. That's the secret.
Figures.
Your spirit had changed from food today. I just woke up.
Hey, that got me jiggle on water. Jiggle on water. Hey, that got water cup. A water cup. Got me jiggle on water. Let's see what's up, man. You ready? Okay, a water cup. Yeah, boy. I mean, jiggle on water. Have a holiday. Hey, 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 hey,
hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey,
yeah, thanks, lady.
Well. God the
mother.
Okay, sounds
perfect.
Nice.
Hi, John.
He's back.
I'm back. This
looking
morning.
Good, man. You got interesting facial hair.
How bad it was. I mean, I'm pretty sure.
And as usual, dapper as can be. And the shoes, I knew it. I was going to, oh, what's in the bottom? Of course. Duck feet.
How long was it?
Dr. Seuss would be proud.
Peace to Johnny the filmmaker. Berkeley dessert. Bobby Raw in town. Just for a moment.
The next movie, part two?
Oh, yeah, three.
Part one, two, and three in there.
Well, three is part being two. Made.
There's one and two. That's the one I'm in. It's the first one.
You're Ninja Boy in the third one.
Am I?
I was looking at that footage going, this guy looks like Ninja Boy!
Oh, yeah.
Now we can make a whole character out of that. Ninja Boy could run around and do some shit.
Yeah. Ninja Boy's probably already been running around doing some stuff.
Oh, yeah, that we don't know about.
Yeah. Or that, you know, you don't know about.
Yeah.
Somebody does.
You don't even know about.
Wrong place, wrong time. Hopefully not. But wait a minute, I've seen that.
That's no good, man.
Oh,
reaching into the wrong dumpster, but you found the fingernail polish.
Yeah,
it's scary.
Man, in the wrong girl's locker.
Hello. What's up? See how cool it is, kids, to smoke stogies? Don't do it. It's bad for you. It kills you. Hello. I am one handsome man. Give me a kiss.
Kid. We'll be right back.
talk about other people every time you fucking see someone talking to themselves? Fucking shit talk. I wish you got that on tape. I wish people like you get caught for shit talk. Try to get your woman to shit talk and make me look bad to get better props with your woman and say racism. And then say I'm the cause of your whole problems. Sorry for doing that.
Can I get a couple pieces of chalk?
Yeah.
Please.
Of course. Artistic.
Yeah, very artistic.
Yeah, write something political, please.
Political? Like what? Yeah,
I don't know. Stop global warming, you know.
Love piece of chicken grease.
There we go.
All right. Beautiful. I know how to draw a piece of chicken, too.
Okay, awesome.
Another call. Hello. Margo? Can you hold? I got Marge and Charlie on the other line. Yeah, and I got food in my mouth. Yeah. Yeah, I'll call you right back. Oh, hello. Hello. Who's this? Mom? Mom, come on. Can I call you back? I got Marge and Charlie and Margo on the other lines. No, I don't have call waiting. Okay, I'll try to call you back, Mom. Love you. Okay. Hello. Who's this? Bart?
Hey, sir. Only in Berkeley.
Oh, John, you got your camera out, man. I traded this hat for this other hat that I paid over $100 for, man. You know? You should have seen it, man. You would have loved it, John. And I made it back to the streets of Berkeley.
Where'd you go?
My lawyer advised me, go the other way, man. There's an outstanding warrant hanging over your head for $2.5 solid county. And you know what? I'll take my chances in the sovereign state of California at Berkeley. Bless the Lord. You know what I'm saying, John?
Yeah.
Bless the Lord. Freedom, the... Why, how'd it go? Habeas corpus delicti, 1782. Bring the body, dead or alive. And I told my lord over the phone in London, my lord, the corpse is very much alive. Bring me forth to the court. You know, I gave it to a stranger. He thought I was another fruitcake man and had me tossed in the jug, man. He knew what I was talking about. And I had a black lawyer, you know. And he was cool, man. His name was Kobe Shenshaw. I told him, man, I'm a minority, you're a minority. You know what it cost me to get out of there, man? Over $4,000 in American money turned into pounds, okay? And he got it. Now I'm a free man. And then they robbed me in the Oakland VA trying to get breakfast. Hit and run. Broke my glasses and everything. Stole all my ID, my cannabis club card and everything. Now I'm begging on it. If it wasn't for my temporary passport and my New Mexico temporary, I wouldn't even be able to go in the bank. You know what I mean? But I got that. Solid.
So where have you been?
The UK.
And where did you go from here?
I went from here to Albuquerque, and from Albuquerque to the UK, the United Kingdom, and from the Scotland, Ireland, and England, and from England back to Albuquerque, and busted from Albuquerque to Berkeley.
And what?
I had the time of my life, John.
What did you do? Yeah, you went to the mental ward.
Yeah, they threw me in an English nut house.
Well, what did you do before that?
I was hoofing it around, man, all over the campus. All over the fucking campus, I was hoofing around. You know what I mean? I was hoofing it everywhere, man. I was going everywhere. You know, I was really having a good... You got a roach on you, John?
Nope.
Not even a roach? Well, I thank you for the cigarettes. The Guild, Renaissance Community, I've seen you there. I've seen you in Turner's Falls. I've seen you in Greenfield. Man, I've seen you around. Northampton.
Northampton?
Northampton.
How about Nashville?
Nashville too, man. I've seen you in Nashville.
So what about Bill Clinton? Where's he at?
I haven't seen him in years, man. The last time I seen him, I loaded up his pipe. He came in my house. Man, I thought I was hallucinating. And the guy that brought him in ended up dead. And I had to go to his funeral. Man, I told Pat, what are you doing bringing these kind of people into my house for? And all he was cute, and he was disillusioned with the neighbors. He hated the mayor, but he was there getting him a job. You know, a six-figure income. Whatever six figures are. But my math is lousy, okay? And I gave him a six-pack of beer, some loose tuna that I had that was laying around for 3 days. I made him a couple sandwiches. And I loaded up his pipe with a rock, and the bottom of it was lined with grass. And he smoked it. And then he left with three Secret Service agents. And I tried to get the Secret Service to try it, but they were disillusioned by it. They didn't smoke that shit. You know what I mean? And they just left, man. You still selling all that stuff, all the movies?
Yep.
You still got all your stuff stashed?
Oh, yeah.
Well, good for you, John. Don't lose it.
No, I won't.
You gotta straighten out my bank account. You might escape from a nut house in downtown London and everything. This guy looked just like Sirhan Sirhan. And I looked at him in the nut house, and I started to question the guy, you know, in my head. I told him, hey, man, if I was a cop, I would ask you for some ID, you know? And this guy went right through the window and landed 18 floors down. You should have seen the mess. I'm an eyewitness to it. Now, I went through, in the last 3 days, about $5,000 that I want you to look up on the computer. I got a new address to give you. They robbed me an hour ago in the VA in Oakland. They hit and run. They got my wallet. All I got is my passport and a temporary New Mexico ID to deal with you. Okay? And you wouldn't believe the mess I'm in financially. My finances are in chaos. And I'm a financial mess. The U.S. government had to put me on a plane that I had to pay for down the road with a temp passport to get out of the U.K. What a ball I had. You wouldn't believe it.
You escaped.
The nut house.
That's good.
And got on the plane. They tried to ruin it.
I tried to push it, but everybody's running it and making copies of it, and I don't know what the hell they're doing. And I said, yeah, I want a little percentage, but God, I didn't think that far ahead. Damn, hey, spring has sprung. Dude, at 10 o'clock, I didn't know that. 10 o'clock, spring starts. Isn't it? That's a first in all my years. Damn, what a life.
I jacked it in the box. It was good.
And you know what? God, I can't believe the order, okay? Extra this, extra that. What did they give me?
They did give me one tomato.
I extra tomato, right? Grilled onions? But extra lettuce, okay. Well, they overdid it on that. No fucking shit, man. Condiments? Mayo. One side only, right? I got it. All right, look. No extra tomatoes. You didn't give me them. Extra tomatoes. Extra grilled onions. Lettuce is fine. But damn. You ever see that movie? Fuck.
Yeah,
that movie? Peter Graves, you know. Seeds, you know, that came from around. Big seeds. They carry them around. And everybody's running embryonic issues, man. That's a good one.
Get that fucking camera out of my face.
Hey, but then I'm like, I love you're beer. Out there listening, we need money for beer. Just send
it
to Telegraph.
Yeah, dude, give me a shit ton of money for some beer.
I have to, and I have to copy the check, I have to copy the affidavit, I got the affidavit filled out, and otherwise I gotta send that in. So I gotta do all this stuff today, because I'm meeting the landlord to give his money tonight, and he has to get all the two letters and the copy of the affidavit, and you know, it's just a million shit.
Who are you?
Crap.
Are you with Bow Wow Wow?
Yeah. What is song that?
Camera's on him, dudes.
I want candy.
I forgot that song. The Bow Wow Wow one? Too long ago, I can't remember.
We'll change it to I Want Pansy.
Yeah!
very interesting.
This is Matthew reporting from the CIA.
Nice to meet you.
Acquired information on two of the targets we've been stalking for the last 18 months.
One of the names is Johnny.
One of the names is
Johnny,
is Johnny, Johnny, aka Alan Shaw Productions.
I can't sleep at night.
We've seen.
And now I'm saying this pizza's so good. It's so good.
Hands on
But you can't meet me.
I don't even know what happened.
You can't meet me, but let me just.
There's a camera behind me.
This must have been some part of the project that we've been doing here. It's all part of the project, so.
Standard issue.
If you happen to see this, don't sweat it.
And we toss our shit.
We're nowhere and everywhere.
All at the same time.
Precisely.
Not.
That's our pose. This is our pose right here. In case you wanted to know.
Don't step on the video!
Don't step on the video!
You heard the man.
You heard the man.
Yeah.
Look at her face right now. That's everyone right now. That's the whole world looking at you. That's the entire. Yeah, just boom. Boom. How did you even handle that? How are you still alive after that?
Are we done here?
I don't know about that.
And cut.
Can you help us? You know where UC Berkeley is?
Did you score any change for food today? Did you score any change?
Ask me, you know where UC Berkeley is?
Lost another bundle at the races this morning. I went, damn liquor store wasn't open. Liquor store wasn't open, so I started eating licorice. Spider looked at me like, you know, like, you try to talk to me, you know? Then I remember this case of champagne in the corner, you know? And then this other fool decided to be sick all day. Ever been sick all day? Well, remember, ain't no reason for nobody to die nowadays. They don't know everything's figured out. Everything's completely figured out. The bigger bottles, less milk. That's what it all means, really. I don't know about the hokey pokey or this cider, but, you know, I don't know. Good luck. Rots a rock.
Sabbat shalom.
This is not marijuana. Come on.
So what's up? Did they take him, like...
I don't know yet.
Did they take him downtown or what?
No.
Get money on the movie. Hi, Johnny. I don't know what you're doing when your camera's on my face.
It's not cute. You got like little ribs on your little like spine on your front.
You should see the other spine on my face. That's weird.
See, one out here get money, man.
Damn, I should have snagged that. Fuck.
I got one in two. S-T-U-D. Stop with you.
I'm just chilling.
See, I didn't get a picture of your ass. Y'all know you were the only person on the goddamn video. You know that?
Okay, so here's my website.
Okay.
You want that? Okay, it's www.brendawalz.com. Child. Got it? You're happy looking in the in your viewfinder. Isn't it strange to know which lens to look through, your regular eyes or your... No, I know.
I'm perfectly adapted.
I know. You're lucky you have such good vision.
You don't?
It's changing.
Yeah.
But I've got to run. So my pleasure. Thank you.
Says your email on your website?
Yeah, you can get there and you can send me a note.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. I'm looking forward to seeing this.
Thank you.
And I'll walk back.
Okay.
I'll come back.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Are we? I ain't got no money. Say you can hardly go to sleep. Then in your big nigga gave me a silver credit you talking about on TV. He got 60 of them. I bought them for $100 for me free in you on Telegraph. I'm on. Ain't nothing over. I'm gonna read that. Let it all out there. Silver credit. Ooh! I don't need it. 300 million. I know I'm really good at it.
I can't get my picture on that.
Let me run.
Do they have your picture on gotcha. Every
They like fucking... it on the bus. They get me on the bus.
You're going to have your picture on every goddamn bus. Bus wanted guide in the fucking
bus
USA.
Wanted.
Don't
bus
fuck
wanted.
With the guy.
So what are you doing today in Telegraph Ave?
I am getting my 5,000 tapes from my mother's house.
5,000 tapes?
Cassette, yes. I have the biggest cassette.
Stella?
No, they're mine. It's the biggest collection in the world. He films me every day, and we make maybe $100,000 a year off the tapes. Off
the lady with the chicken.
Chicken. She's laughing from the chicken.
What?
She's laughing because she ate the laughing chicken. Calling all cars. Katie and 92725 to base. Katie and 9, we have liftoff. Katie and 92725 to base. We have Houston control. We have liftoff. This is one small step for mankind and one large step for Gaddafi. Winnie the Pooh, chubby old little all stuffed with fluff. He's Winnie the Pooh, stuffy old fluffy old bear. Christopher Robin was walking through the park and he ran into Eeyore. Dun 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 dun. What kind of fun? Why, story fun. I'm here to tell you the story of the gingerbread boy. Dun-dun-dun-dun. The gingerbread. Once upon a time, there was a man and an old lady. They couldn't have children of their own, so they decided to bake a gingerbread boy. Two cherries for eyes, a raisin for a nose, and at 12 o'clock, out popped the gingerbread boy. Da-dun-da-dun-dun, da-dun-da-dun, and on he ran until he met a cow. You moo. You may be able. How now, you fine brown cow? But you can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread boy. And I ran from an old man and an old lady, and I'll run from you. And on he ran until he met a pig. While we see it your way, run the chance of knowing that our love will soon be gone. We can work it out. We can work it out. Think of what you're saying. We can get it wrong, and still you think that it's all right. Think of what I'm saying. We can get it right, and then we can stay all. We can work it out. We can work it out. Life is very short, and there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend. I have always thought that it's a crime, but I will ask you once again. Try to see it my way. Only time will tell if I am right or I am wrong. He can sing good on that. Is it true? Ron said, my love is Fool on the Hill backwards. They just play it backwards. That's scary. Day after day, alone on a hill, my love does it good. That's scary. They just play it backwards. Can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street?
You got a quarter?
What, is my skin flaking? What's so funny, guys? Come on, man. Please. Please. Just let me massage. my moisturizer into the skin. What are you guys, the fucking cops?
It's not funny. Make a movie about the inner me, the inner child in me. Make a movie about me, Johnny.
I want to see something wacky. The weed's fucking amazing.
Come on, let's get out of here. Let's go smoke some real weed.
We've got the disc. And the chip, the fucking chip. Come on, now we gotta take it away from him while he's still filming. They're peanut butter sandwiches. It says it right there, in writing. Fuck it.
Turn up when I'm eating something like this. You're a bad omen.
Sometimes referred to as higher cumulus. But that's kind of a messy subject. Cirrus stratus. Cumulus nimbus. And higher cumulus. I think higher cumulus. Cumulus nimbus is the. Probably more interesting.
We're standing in Berkeley, California. Behind me is a nuclear reactor. On that hill, behind the stadium, the War Memorial Stadium. I'm involved in a tree sit at the Memorial Oak Grove. What a lot of people in Berkeley here don't understand is that underneath that oak grove is an infrastructure that leads straight to the nuclear reactor. Oh, people they probably don't want that information to get out. What they probably don't want people to know also is those gates. Let's see, I don't know who would want this information. Let's see, a running nuclear reactor with virtually unrestricted access to it. Who would want that kind of information? I don't know. The gates on the sidewalk on Piedmont Avenue by the Oak Grove, yeah, open that up. You'll find an infrastructure that leads straight to a working nuclear reactor. It was working last Thursday night. You know how I know? I checked the vent. Through many and scientific tests, we found out they're lethal. Doses of carbon monoxide coming from that vent. I did a field test with my body. I am an air quality expert with over 10 years experience working in places such as Genentech, the biomedical lab, or Novo Nordisk, another biomedical lab. So I do know what I'm talking about here. Within a minute in that enclosed bubble around that vent, while the nuclear reactor was on last Thursday night, within a minute, I had such lethal doses of carbon monoxide, my friends had to pull me out of there. What people don't realize is that's highly illegal. But then the real question is, well, since it's tied to a nuclear reactor, what else is coming out of there? Because there's nobody to check their hand. Nobody's checking that vent. Well, it raises some big questions. What are they really doing underground over there if they have an infrastructure with doorways that lead straight to a nuclear reactor virtually unprotected? I took a walk down there. I just looked at the manhole 2 days ago. The manhole which leads up to the nuclear reactor if you go inside it, the one that's usually not locked. I looked at it and I was thrown in prison for looking at that gate. Oh, you want to see my prison tag? It's right here. There's my mugshot. See, I still have it on, because that's how recent it was. If my dad didn't bail me out of jail, I'd be in Santa Rita right now for looking at that gate. Yeah, they know I know, but I know they know. Yeah. let's talk about my dad. He was in the Pakistani army in the 60s. And then comes to America to work on basically some of their most highly guarded defense secrets. Yeah, he's been under FBI surveillance since the 60s. Yeah, he knows. He knows the game a lot better than I do. And he doesn't talk because he's scared. He's really fucking scared.
You bubbling idiot. What the fuck?
You jerk me around again.
Expect to fucking... for me not to notice that you weren't home. I rang your doorbell 65 times. Why? Why did you lie?
Spotlight's on you.
Good thing to hear.
Especially when they buy it.
Let me tell you a little bit about myself. I'm okay. Tony Serrato, half man, half amazing, one touch, a thousand quivers, standing in the shadows of love. Don't leave home without me. Under the cover of darkness, I strike. Share the fannies. This is my amigo, Fernando, and some other patrons here at this wonderful La Tienda, if you will. And foreman, Peter Perrin, another champion, half man, half amazing. Lunch is ready.
UFO. Oh, you know they come over here and like fucked everybody in the ass and look at the shit we got. Look at this shit. Half these people are aliens. No, hey, how you doing today? Welcome to the show. We are just about to do an episode of Jackass. I'm going to attempt to do free speech in the belly of the fascist Bush America. Now I'm going to try to go on and on and on. Say Bush is an idiot until the black helicopters show up and haul me off to Site 51, where I will be reassembled as a Republican, voting for McCain again, again, and again. Because we know that the virtual fence that they're putting on the South of America is the virtual fence that the iPod puts on your brain. You know, people can live in whole different universes now. Instead of living with you in Berkeley in the year 2008, they can live in L.A. a couple days ago, 2006, with their buddies. Don't even have to get to know you. I tell you, Berkeley's a beautiful place. Got beautiful trees with beautiful people. And that's what this whole moment is about right here. Sir, how you doing today? Visiting Cal Berkeley?
My English is
also. I'm the chancellor. Bergen out. There you go. Now they'll believe that the chancellor of Berkeley is some green-haired, bald-headed, unemployed white guy.
Hey, homeless guy, want to come over and sleep in my garden tonight? Our sprinkler comes on at like 4 a.m. That's all you got to do is get out of the way of the sprinkler. But you're welcome to sleep in our garden. Can I buy you a beer, pizza, anything like that? I'll tell you what. If you'd like to, you can sleep in our garage tonight.
Have you thought about branching out in movies for grown-ups? Surely some women have asked whether they have a future in cinema. And you say, well, let's come up to my play suite thing and we'll see. Check out what's going on. Go up to the lab and see what's on the slab.
Have a nice day.
Yeah! Hell yeah!
I've been walking up and down the street since 82 doing this.
What? Yeah!
You gotta set it up.
Oh, man, sure. I'm still living.
They're all Fisher for his first movie. Why do you want to make a new movie? Guys, but you hand it over for the next one.
Wondering whether you had hooked up with Donald Trump, I mean Ken Saracen, but you know, obviously you had more fish on the line than I thought.
Well, you gotta make one for the camera.
Why, when I'm always on, do you have to resort to cheap chicanery, cheap tricks, cheap video shots of some idiot, huh? Why? That's what we want to know. I'll tell you why. Because they like it like that. Sorry. That's why. The fuck? That's why we all like it like that. Some of us more than, some of us are dramatic, some of us are comedic. I, unfortunately, am a failure at both. Thank you. Have a good day. Have a bud. Yeah. Want to see a big bag of bud? Where's that? Might have a big bag. Come on.
No, dude, don't make me a...
See? Ah, whoa! Woo! Nice, huh? That's some purple herb. Ooh, smell that. Smell that, Mr. Cameraman. Man, never mind. Here, have a bud for your troubles. Okay. He's not really getting bud. This is not really marijuana. There's no transaction taking place. This is not marijuana. Does this look like marijuana to you, boys and girls? This is called Urkel. It's very good. It's, that's too much. That's too much.
Not enough?
It's too much. Yeah, but that's all right. You got your hands.
I didn't wash my hands.
I don't care.
Curses
spoiled again. All right, enough video camera. Go away. Bye. You're gonna have a nice day. Have a nice life. See you later. Get the fuck out of here. Go kick rocks. I love you. Thank you for this chance for me to have some sun, have some attention, have the reflection placed upon me, which I feel I so resoundingly deserve. I want this aired sometime or other on the public access channel. Damn it. B-Town. Whatever that is. No more meth. Did I say that? Yeah, no more meth, motherfucker. That means you and you and you. And you. And you. Okay, I've talked enough to the video camera. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure having you here, or being here with you, or sharing this time together. And in truth, I wish I could sell more bud, just make lots of money, and just make you a permanent fixture of my establishment. Or at least...
Go punch aid. Larry.
Yeah, ooh, good dog. Mark, he was supposed to pay me. Of course, now, we never really have transactions. We never really buy pot or meth. No.
Once again on the streets of... Berkeley, but I ain't gonna die today.
take me 1 minute out of midnight. You can take me 1 minute anyway. You can take me 1 minute out of Berkeley. But I ain't gonna die in Berkeley, not today. Because look around, man, would you die in Berkeley today? Because it's just too damn beautiful. Oh, I'm gonna drop. No way. That's where it is. That's what it is. That's where it goes. Oh, take me 1 minute after midnight. Don't take me today. Because it's just too damn good looking. I'm sorry. It is what it is. If it ain't what it is, then it is what it is. That's all what it is. Huh. I'm not trying to be no fool. But not today, not today. Giddy up, ride them ponies. Giddy up, ride them ponies. But I ain't going out today. You know.
It was called 1985. It was written in 1973. And if you listen to it, you can go back or forth through time. That's what it was written for.
So what happened?
If you bought the record Band on the Run in 1973 and you were listening to it and you fall asleep in your house, you'll wake up in 1985, which is 12 years later, and you won't have remembered any of it. And that happens to a lot of people. And then you can go back through time through the same hole. But most of time travel is done through light, through like this, traveling at the speed of light. And sometimes it helps if you're on drugs, but it's pretty easy to do now.
So you said you can go to a TV show?
No, I can walk right into a painting or a TV show. If I'm watching a 1951 episode of Lucy, I can just walk right on the set. And I walk out the door of Fred's apartment building. I'm in downtown New York in the 50s. Spend a couple weeks there and then come back to the 90s or 80s or wherever I want.
And you remember any of it?
Yeah, I can do it. It's real. Okay. It's not a dream, man. When I was in Hawaii, I was mad because the Hawaiians were being shut off their land. This is recently, and I fell asleep, and this guy goes, I said, where am I? He goes, you're in 1968 in Berkeley, and everybody here is upset with their time, and there were people from all different times in this dorm, and I said, what's going to happen? He goes, if you pay $40, you can stay for a while. Otherwise, you can walk down the stairs now, as long as you don't wake up out of your dream, and you'll be in Berkeley in 1968. And I said, that's wild. I walked down the stairs and came, started walking down the street, and then I woke up. But that's that, you can do it, man. That was like my first step to like time travel.
Not nearly as entertaining as getting Sam up, wasn't
it? So a cop shot me unarmed. So what happened was the city had to pay me off, and then I moved away from Texas. I was like out of there. I was like, fuck that.
Man, the cops just shot
you. And I'd never been busted. Never for nothing. Well, no, they were looking for a guy that stole a car that had long black hair.
Stole a car?
Stole a car.
Oh, stole a car.
And he had long black hair, and there I am walking down the sidewalk with long black hair, and that was their excuse for shooting me unarmed in the knee. Broad daylight. As soon as it happened and I collected the money from the city, I knew to.
Did you get the cop back?
Oh, the cop got busted. They busted the cop.
Good.
It took a year to find the cop. A whole year to find the cop. My attorney, what they did is they got him in an apartment and they paid his electricity bill so they could find his bills. So the attorney took
They couldn't find his what?
They couldn't find him because he didn't have any bills because the cops were paying his bills. It was in their name. Finally, the attorney located the cop, served him my papers.
How did they find him?
I don't know. An investigator that works for my attorney found the cop. Now, I don't know how much money the attorneys made out of it, and I don't know how much the attorneys paid the cops, but as soon as the lawsuit came up, the idea was the attorney said, I can't say anything about what happened or talk about it at all to any kind of public or anything like that. That was part of the deal. As long as I get my settlement, as long as I don't say anything about it to any more news cameras. So they really tried everything. Texas is corrupt. Totally corrupt. That's why I live here in Berkeley.
You got the cop.
Oh, the cop got busted for it.
And he got put into jail.
He didn't go to jail. Cops don't get put in jail. They only get fined.
I hate the cops.
Cops aren't considered citizens by the government. They're not citizens. Yeah. They're exempt from citizenship.
Wow.
So it's like a military person or even a judge is exempt from citizenship. They can do things we can't. Yeah. That's why you see them riding on the sidewalk and doing things that they give other people tickets for, because they're allowed to do that. They're not citizens by law. They're not, and they aren't. They're serving the country, and at that point,
asshole got away with it.
Okay. Well, you know, the whole government's designed to so it's going to rule. You know, everything. Ever since the Roman Catholic Church came in, took away all the knowledge, astrology, took away the Kabbalah, and said, "Hey, you're not allowed to know who you are. You're not allowed to know knowledge. You can't learn. You know, it's a sin to know." About, you know, I mean...
So this cop shot in the knee.
Yeah, I was shot in the knee at 30. But it did a lot of good things for me at the same time, because you've got to understand, I mean, not... What happened was, I was on drugs, and I was touring around with a band around the world. So I wasn't doing... So it made me get off... It was my Saturn return. Uh-huh. And I have Saturn and Capricorn in my ascendant, which rules the knee. So on my Saturn return, I lost my knee. It helped me get off of hard drugs, a lot of the things that I was doing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So there's negative things, good things always come. There's always that positive, negative thing. So through hardships, negative things, good things come. And I can't blame all cops for what one cop did, even though they are all corrupt. It's really sad because they're corrupt. Yeah. But, you know, you can't let it get to you or my life or affect me, so I keep going, you know, and having fun.
Hey, dude!
How are you?
Oh, my God, dude!
Johnny Allen Shaw.
What's up? How are you?
Making movies.
Peace, man.
What's up, man?
Well, I had a chance to come out here to downtown Berkeley in a nice festival, World Music Festival, and about the populations of 12 galaxies on the White House with prejudice, war crimes, embezzling my money, some movie stars. So, already met at Jimmy Carter's, Nancy Pelosi's, Dennis Kucinich, and probably that was Madison's, John Hancock's, Monroe's. Talking to me in person as former presidents and about the populations of the galaxies regarding me as a movie star. So I'm trying to get it all proven 2009 in Washington, D.C., and trying to get the impeachments also.
All right. Beautiful, gorgeous Friday afternoon in Berkeley, California.
Hello, I'm John Denver, and we're going to do John Denver songs now. Button Flasty, fattin' on the right. Kiss moon in midnight, shaking on my country road. Take me home to the place. I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, hello. Hello. Anyway, we got a wild show for you tonight. And I'm Les Claypool. Have you seen your mother, baby? Oh, wait a second. What am I doing? Well, you're the countess and you meet that certain
I'm John Denver with the silver in my smile and a gold plating doing mile after mile on the karaoke dial. What do you think of that? Who are you? By the way, I'm looking at you a little closer. Who are you?
Mary.
Mary who?
Mary, Quick and Trey.
Oh, come on. Touching down in New England town. How you doing? I'm Oscar Mayer Wiener. Hi. Who are you? I just met you. I'm a puppet. Baby, baby.
Who am I? I don't know. Who am I? David Bowie, by chance? You shouldn't mess with me. I'll save you everything you are. I'll give you television. I'll give you eyes of blue. Oh, baby, just you shut your mouth.
One last kiss before I walk out the door. I'm Arnold Schwarzenegger. Do you know who I am?
I'm a country music western singer. John Denver Jr. Hi, how are you? I'm John Denver Jr. It's the John Denver Jr. Show. How are you? Are you sure you're John Denver? Well, if you're John Denver, I'm John Denver Jr.
Whatever. Hi. Hi. Who? Who might you be? I'm David Bowie.
I'm Mick. I'm the Mick Jagger of today. But I'm actually David Bowie. Oh, Suzy Q. Oh, Suzy Q. Oh, Suzy Q. David Bowie loves you. Suzy Q. I like the way you walk. Oh, baby, shut your mouth. Like the way you talk. I like the way you walk, I like the way you talk. You little China girl, you shouldn't mess with me. I'll ruin everything you are.
Hi, I'm Les Claypool. I'm the new Les Claypool around here. Hey, I talk outside my mouth, why? Because I'm Les Claypool. Anyway, what's for supper?
Oh God, I'd love to, oh, if I could just meet Janis Joplin. I haven't, oh, I thought she was, woof.
Woo, woo, who are you?
Oh, David fucking Bowie. Oh, David Bowie.
David fucking Bowie. Are you screwing around with me?
Imagine me and you, I do. Come on, come over here and clap your hands. Everybody's doing a brand new dance now. Come on, baby, do the...
When you're dim and you're weak, you got the teeth of the heart upon you. You're David Bowie and you're my girl. I catch the people bored when things don't really sing. I'm standing in the wind, but I never wave I by. But I try. I try. Let me analyze you. You shouldn't mess with me. I'll ruin everything you are.
I'll give you television. I'll give you eyes of blue. I'm Marlon Brando. I'm like a sacred clown. I stumble into town. We have David Bowie.
You know, you guys have been really good today. I don't know if I could have done it without you.
Ah, oh, you did it for purpose?
What's going on, man?
Huh?
Huh?
Are you put back in the corner right now or what?
No.
You did this?
No.
You
was, oh, it's a good idea though.
You must try to look like
me. No, I just saw you over here.
Oh really?
Yeah. What's going on, man?
Same old shit. Make a certain movie?
Third
I'm
one.
I'm in a certain movie.
The last one.
Why the last one? This is like it's the
three,
Star Wars
man.
Kind of
enough episode. Already, enough.
Enough?
There's got to be an end.
Dude, I stole my idea, yeah?
Oh, I stole your idea.
I stole
I like
my
that.
Idea in Hollywood.
Alright.
I don't like the shitty, I'm the one. I mean, like, I saw, like, this movie, what was it? Gaul? And this chick is with this guy, like, in the bed. And he wears, like, underwear like this. It's totally upturner, you know? Totally, no, downturner, actually. I would never wear shit like this. It's, like, so boring, man. Oh, wow, this is cool. I take this one. A letter from the NBA? Department of Corrections and Rehabilitations. I see you.
Secondly, power the people down to earth. Psychedelics.
Yeah.
Peace and love, summer of love.
Where are you from?
The universe. The universe, the planet Earth.
Good, das geht.
Auch ein Italien?
Alles ziemlich an. Das geht.
It's good, I'm gonna buy that stuff come next month.
반드시 드라마 해당이 되는데 스트롱 조신아 주담 스 비자르 스트롱 아무나 나죠. 모스 펜테스 오 스트롱 조나 잡아라죠. I like the very discipline.
Computer up there, all the parts are ripped, there's the parts.
Hey, how's Teddy?
Teddy who? He's alright.
Alright, cool.
What are you doing? How are you doing?
I'm okay. I was sick the other day, but I recovered.
Right on.
Hey,
is that how you got in? You're on the rest.
The video right here is about me and my friend going out into like basically we got hella drunk on grandma's wine and we went out basically we drove off in this car which we weren't supposed to take and got hella drunk and like parked it on the side of a hill and like was staring at the stars for hours and. Basically, grandma's wine is just like some hallucinogenic shit. Shit'll fuck you up.
Make a video.
Here, let's see if we can get this. See if we can hear it on there.
A little bit. Good enough.
Gotta give up your ego. Gotta give up ego and express your true self.
It all started when I fell asleep in 1973 and woke up in 1985. And it was hard. We're gonna close our eyes. We should really do a video of the time I went back to 1968. I've been to 2 Jimi Hendrix concerts in England through time travel. Ladies and gentlemen, this is brought to you by Bear Aspirin. The kind of aspirin that gives you a headache. And the next time we see you, we will talk about the time when Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2 met up with Eeyore and Christopher Robin and Piglet. I'm here to tell you the story of the gingerbread boy. Once upon a time, there was a man and a lady. An old man and an old lady. They couldn't have children of their own, so they decided to bake a gingerbread boy. 2 cherries for eyes, a raisin for a nose, and at 12 o'clock, out popped the gingerbread boy. Dun 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 dun, dun 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 dun, the gingerbread boy, and on he ran until he met a dog. Have you ever heard that story? You know that Mayan's hearts only beat 59 times a minute? And coke leaves were introduced to this planet from their planet 80,000 years ago. So that they could survive in our atmosphere. That's a true story. And right as of now, Barack Obama has 32 states, McCain has 28 states, including the District of Columbia is going to Obama. The reason Obama's ahead in Georgia is because of the Libertarian candidate, Barr. He's from Georgia, so he's taking McCain's votes away there. That's the same reason Barack Obama's ahead in North Dakota. Guild, the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild. We represent the Lollipop Guild. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Opium poppies, follow the yellow brick road. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Toto! That way. You are the straw man.
Ah! You owe me a dollar. I would have kept the quarter. Oh no, we did it for a dollar, that's right.
Thanks, John. Frank.
Cheap.
Thank you.
He wins and he still tries to finagle another quarter out. Did you get that?
Hey, man, I feel in my face, brother. God is looking out after me again today, folks. May us all bless the Lord. Bless the Lord Jesus Christ, man.
I found a mystery of someone who seemed to be running a computer program from their unconscious. And finally, through Inner Light Publications, Timothy Green Beckley's UFO and alternative energy research, I came across a woman who wrote the same way, who was a survivor of a CIA mind control project called MKUltra. And she was in and around the White House, and NASA installations was tortured, and similar stuff to what Jenna talks about. She married a federal agent who deprogrammed her. Okay, there's certain code words that trigger something, and I'm still analyzing it, and I think I've got close to 500 or 600 pages of her stuff and maybe 500 of my own posters. So it, when I got off of drugs and I kicked a 15-year heroin habit, being a professional jazz musician, it was a lot of physical pain. That first year, just something hit me, like what the Sicilians will call a thunderbolt. You know, I must have some kind of Russian-Jewish background. You know, a few drops of that blood in there, you know. So, anyway, 467-8187, we're on MySpace/DRSHABUBU, and I'd like to wish you and yours happy holidays. I think they're all this weekend, right? We have the first day of spring, Purim, Christian Easter, the Persians have their Nowruz. So I'm out for the party. Sorry, these aren't more put. These are what the peace. Peace says they're a healing eye, they're a loving eye, and I've been demonstrating with the Tibetans about the human rights abuses in Tibet, and a lot of them are unaware that the Chinese are imprisoning Falun Gong practitioners and harvesting their organs and selling them on the internet. And I think that's terrible, you know, and I'm not getting a dime out of it.
What's going on?
Man,
Toby,
I might have
come
been
here. This.
Yeah, I might have.
Toby,
I'm not sure, but
Mark.
A lot of people weren't sure
in
those days.
What are you doing? Say hi. Say hello.
I've been here for 7 years now, and I've never had a complaint yet. Well, I've had two for 7 years, so that isn't bad. But they were kind of... They said they had been talking to God. I don't know, have you talked to God lately? I haven't. But they were like really just, I think, you know, a lot of wing nuts are attracted to this area. There's something that holds Berkeley together. My friend told me the other day, there's a wing nut on every corner. Well, it's kind of like a modern day Rome. I mean, I think about 200 years from now, people are really going to be talking about how Berkeley was this place who started things and how everything was experimented on and the new things happened here. Well, it's like a new frontier. It's like... What would they call it? There's a vortex here. A lot of my friends in magical practice, and I have a lot, say that there's a vortex here, and it's the meeting of the current coming from the north and the east coming from this way. And it's actually the fault line itself is... I took my parents up here when they came here a few years ago, and I took them up so they could take care of the Bay Area, and I said, well, we're standing on the most major fault, you know? And they're like, wow, we are, you know? They thought it was cool, you know? It's that risk factor, I guess. Usually I'm not photogenic because I have Capricorn rising and Capricorn Saturn in the first house, but due to my older age, it's made me more wise and stay more out of trouble. To where in the younger age, Capricorn's old when you're young, young when you're old. I went through many problems. Then to overcome it at 30 at my Saturn returns. So, I don't know. I feel after my midlife, I've totally changed me to a more positive way. To where when the 80s I was like traveling around in a punk rock band, touring the world, but it was very, I don't regret it. It was very fun, a very interesting thing, but totally turned me around once I turned to an older age and started becoming more enlightened and more into spiritual and inner things.
I don't think you're telling the truth.
Oh, look at Mike, look at that.
Thank you.
I bench press 400. Like, I know a guy that knocked me down, but he can bench press 500. I only bench press 400.
It's an insult. This is good. Come on.
That's the Lord?
That's the Lord.
Hey, yeah. For posterity, man. That filled through my words.
What's the Lord's name in this?
Lightning, amen.
Lightning, amen.
Oh, it's Jesus lightning. Christ lightning.
Right.
You heard it?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
The Jesus Christ Lightning family in person.
The Christ family. That'd be us, man.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Right on. Tell me about your... let's hear some of your philosophy. What's going on?
The keys to heaven. No killing. No sex. Except responsible sex. No killing means animals also. And no materialism. You can't get over on people. You can't worship things man-made more than you worship people that God made. People, brothers and sisters, the most important thing in this whole world.
Huh?
Love.
Telling everybody be nice, rejoice, and enjoy. Be a peacemaker. No support in the wars.
Right on. That's
no killing.
Got to
end it.
Got
to stop it.
Amen.
And love each other the way you love yourself. But do anything you want in your life, but do it in the name of the Lord and do it in the establishment of His kingdom, because His kingdom is happening right now on earth. We live there. He's got 20 years of personal knowledge, and I've got 18 years of personal knowledge. We have dinner with him. He has a family meal every night. He's heard about it. Amen. We play pool.
We have St. Bart, and I'm in Berkeley.
Almost every night.
How well does Jesus play pool? Like, what kind of pool player is he?
Well, you know, if he wanted to clean our clock, he could. But, you know, he lets us all win. We all win. That's the thing about being in the kingdom. We all win.
So, if Jesus is back, and he's an old man by this point, he's been among us for, you know, a couple generations at this point, how come everybody doesn't know?
Gets undercover.
What's why?
The greatest... check this out. Two-thirds of the world's going to perish, brother. The greatest camouflage...
Yeah, let me explain.
The greatest camouflage ever conceived is what's the reason why he's not on TV in the newspaper. That camouflage is truth.
Uh-huh.
Nobody believes it.
How many in the family now?
100, 120 that are, there was a bunch, there were say over they say about a 300 to 400 brothers and sisters have laid down their lives, liquidated their possessions, put on a white robe and went out into the wind.
Every state of mind creates state of being. Where you hang out in your mind is how it perceives your being. You know, if you do good, you'll get good. You reap what you sow in this world, this day and age. That's why it's important to do the right thing, be good, and tell the truth, because it'll all come back into you. The manifestation it brings upon one's being is beautiful.
Amen. Walk through town with a couple of the brothers and sisters, two or three brothers and sisters from that town, put on a white robe and go with them. What do the parents say? He was there one day, he was there one brother, take it away the next.
Right on.
Just to take care of people.
Silence the violence, you feel me? Silence the violence, you feel me?
Buy
and
find
some Joe.
See the young man on the street, buy out.
Can you rewind it and let me see the footage?
Not yet.
Oh, well.
You'll see it on the silver screen in part 3.
Okay.
Maybe.
Or not. I am going to be famous in that case.
Yeah.
limitations.
Where do you want to do this?
I'd like it to be this
three here facing this way. I want it tiny on that side, facing that way. That's that garbage can right there. And then I want to see that truck spot like this. So Tommy goes back at his guy and he bolts for the truck. And the truck will just be stopped, but, yeah. And then we'll see him go over.
You know who that was?
Who?
Tommy Lee.
Tommy Lee who?
Motley Crue.
Tommy who?
They got a new show. Who the fuck are the fabulous Thunderbirds?
The ones closest to your bone, like on your elbow, or your knee, or your... Right here, there's not a whole lot of bone there. It's just cartilage and stuff. So not so bad. But around your bones, or like where it's real sensitive in there, ooh-wee. That's brutal. You don't want none of that.
You don't want to have any of those until you're much, much older.
Yeah. Why, are you thinking about getting one?
Once I got a barbed wire tattoo, there's still a little bit left there.
On your head?
Yeah.
On your head?
Yeah, just a big one. Oh. And somebody tried to give me a real tattoo of the same thing with a tattoo gun.
What? You can't do that until you're 18, then, right?
Yeah.
He had his own tattoo gun and he tried to give me a real one.
Oh, those ones are permanent.
And he tried to show me
how to
feel by pinching me with some tweezers.
That's close. That's
a good lesson, yeah.
That's a close feeling. You know what?
When you're 18, think about getting one of those for real. Not before then, okay? The barbed wire tattoo on the forehead.
The coolest
thing. That would hurt really bad.
That would hurt really bad.
The coolest thing ever, I got to cut a couple nephews that a little bit little than you guys just a few years ago, and we're all sitting in the jacuzzi having a splash around the hot tub, and it was the cutest thing ever. They were taking the water and trying to rub them off of me like they come off. I was like, no, they don't come off. And they were like,
that's because I've been trying to rub the one off his forehead all week. Hey, why don't you come play the 40th anniversary next year?
I got one
already.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why don't you come play next year? We need a big band. You know, this is a really important historical place. You know, they've been trying to take it away from us for years.
And I'm going to need your permission to use this in my third movie.
39 years ago.
Yeah, you can rock it.
Thank you.
Hey, 39 years ago, we took this place from the university. You know, they wanted to build all kinds of crap there. And we've kept it as a green space. The people here in the community, we take care of it ourselves. You know, and we have concerts that, you know, like once a week, you know, a couple, three a month, you know. And, you know, they want to cut all that out. They want to turn it into a parking lot.
So thanks, man.
Yeah, yeah. Just give me an email and we'll talk about it.
Let's talk. Fuck you.
How much money? I know. First bill you got. Pay me, I'll go. Yeah. Damn straight.
Okay, then suppose I will go to the
here we go. Bam!
Alright.
Alright. The earring man. The eerie earring man. Yes, he's crazy. Oh, here comes Butchie, ready to work.
We're out.
Off work.
Yeah.
I got your money.
Hey, man,
save
me a cigarette.
I had yesterday, you went
tell,
around.
Tell me if you do.
I don't have any.
You don't have any. I don't have no cigarette.
You're going to go buy your own.
Buy your own.
Buy your own cigarette. Buy your own. Make your own movie.
Oh, you're going to film me moving this thing and show it to him, huh?
Pretty much.
Cool. So he can get all pissed off. All
right.
But I'm going to be in the third one. And this is how you earn your right to be in the third video. Check it out.
Try not to hate me.
Uh-oh.
Somebody help.
You're going to get hit by that bus, and I'm going to get your car.
Oh. Hey, you steal my shit. What happened?
You didn't do the ollie. You don't get the prize.
Hey, is that your car?
Yes.
Can I skate on it?
Probably not.
Why not?
I see what you've done already.
Oh, you saw me touch it?
No. See, the word can means capable. It comes from the word capable of. Uh-huh. I'm not sure whether you can.
I'm gonna jump over this obstacle and land in the street. You guys ready for it? Hey, Dawn.
I'm moving.
God, my ass.
Who are these people?
I'll try that one more time. That was a shitty stunt right there. I can do way better than that.
There we go. We had Tommy Lee yesterday.
Is that
Tommy
new Lee's Magnum?
Down. Yeah.
Tommy Lee?
Yeah. And he's in the movie now, the third movie with you.
Oh,
you
really?
And, you and Tommy Lee are both big stars now.
What
now,
that
about
money,
the interest rate. I'm going to give you the leading interest rate, 12.75.
Okay, thanks.
Nice.
That's what I owe you, right?
Okay.
So how'd you see Tommy Lee, man?
No, he was in town doing the video reality show. And
yeah, he didn't make the Nebraska fucking college marching band, so he's a loser. Tommy. Plus, I saw fucking Bret Michaels fucking Pam on the fucking internet, bro. How's that, Tommy?
I can't use that.
Yeah. Huh?
How am I going to put that in my third movie?
I don't know. Shit. I got to tell Tommy like it is, man. Your last good album was Shout at the Devil, bitch.
And what happened to Mick Mars?
Just kidding, man.
What did you do to Mick Mars?
Mick Mars? Yeah, what happened to Mick, man? What happened to Mick Mars? Is he all right? He's gay? Is that? He's fucking Mick's
ugly.
Oh, he's ugly? Yeah, because fucking Mick Mars is the only one that didn't take the paint off, man. Because he's too ugly. Shit. He can't play no fucking guitar. Why don't you guys hire Eddie Van Halen or some shit? He doesn't get too many good gigs anymore. Motley Crue, they're basically like a wedding band. All right, that's enough. The interview's done. It's over. Full.
That's it.
Oh, we're gonna be revisiting Berkeley from 1968.
All right.
Yeah, this place when I got in town here is to be two-way street, crunchy street, no asphalt. And it used to be a lot of fun, peace and love, psychedelics. Thank you.
Obama's the wiener?
The big one.
Check
Superstar.
Yeah, it's a bar problem. They give it back to him.
So look who it is, it's T1. Say hi to T1. You know T1? Psychedelic.
Berkeley all day, man.
Okay,
here we go. You're fucked up.
You don't know yet.
What's up to the camera, you know what I mean? Hey, man. T1 app. This ain't Telegraph. It's T1 app. All day selling music, man. I push him.
Get the picture of me. You got the money coming, sis, brother.
Okay.
Turkey balls.
I can't hear you, man.
Turkey balls. Pickle turkey balls.
Pickle turkey balls.
Pickle turkey balls. I didn't want to buy this place. All these cowboys, you know.
Whole jar of pickled turkey balls, you know. guy said, "What are those?" He says, "Those are pickled turkey balls." I said, "Pickled turkey balls." He said, "Pickled turkey balls sounds good, you know." I look at the dog go, no pickled turkey balls for me, but go ahead, you know. So all these cowboys, back away from the bar, like, he's gonna eat a pickled turkey ball. Pickled turkey ball? That's from Motley. That was Christmas. Christmas, I was on my way home. Fucking pickled turkey ball. Have you put the second movie in the store?
Yeah.
It's in the store.
Yeah.
You got it at Rasputin's?
Yeah.
So they can play the second flick?
Yeah.
You got that already down?
Yeah.
Because the first one, all right, you know, after seeing it 10 times, I still fucking laugh. All right? I don't know how you edit. I don't know how you film. You know, this, that, the other thing. But it's like, hey, man, you did one hell of a good artwork. Okay, and I appreciate it for that. All right, they played them a fucking thing like so many fucking times. You know, I mean, like, I look at it, you know, you got the guy in the fucking red suit, right? And I mean, like, I told my mom, right? My mom lives in Orange County in Laguna Beach and works for multimillionaires as a caregiver. I says, "Mom, you gotta come to Berkeley. Because see, in Berkeley, Mom, we got people walking down the streets with rainbow hairdos, okay? And they're going to be a nuclear scientist in a pair of bell bottoms, okay? With long hair, you know, down in the middle of their shoulders. All right, Mom, that's the kind of people we got up here. Now, what the heck do you think I'm living here, Mom?"
"Joint Berkeley, 102 now. After we roll it, we smoke it. So that's what this is all about." "Thank you so much, Johnny, for your social service. And we'll see you on the rebound."
"Different name in a different face, in the space, in another race. That's what took place in the sea of tranquility in the human race. All putting aside for the ones that hide. Get out your closet, man. It's time to ride. Apocalypse now. Let's all decide whether a different space and a different race put you and I in our place. Me, myself, we're running high. For the next word I say, I'll up and die. And I'll go to the rest of the space and the twisters and the names of the crater place."
"My name is Free Ka.
The telegraph
is like
for me. He new and Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
banda, andaluces, indios, que son lenguas, bengalí o
other language.
Yeah, no, he was saying, used to sing Fuma Hashish and chant.
Something like that.
Oh, yeah. He was saying that. You know who should record
call
this guy?
Me somewhat like Mr.
The little guy, have you seen the little guy? Black guy who says
fish pitching!
Oh, the
yeah.
Alright.
Good to see you, buddy. Good to see you.
I'm looking for someone with a brain and a driver's license. It's not him. It's not him. I'm telling you, it's not him.
It's a snake.
Hey, buddy.
What kind of snake is it?
It's a rat snake. But it's leucocystic, so it's blue eyes. It's not albino. It doesn't bite them at all. It's totally human. It's raised at the Bavarian.
Hey, how's it going?
Woo!
Did you?
No. I don't know whose camera it is.
You wanted to be in the video.
It's locked. I don't know what to do. Okay. You gonna watch me poop? Who's?
What's your name?
That's Marc Biedermann right there. He's my good buddy. He's a legend of rock.
And what did he play for?
Primus. Metallica.
And?
Primus.
He played for Primus.
Blind Illusion is the name of the band. From Richmond.
Who the fuck are you?
We're the good old shit.
Whoa. March. March. Yeah, you gotta get over here. Yes, Marc Biedermann's here. Okay, alright, I'll see you in a few. Bye.
Don't care. Oh, it's me.
actually drummer. From Blind Illusion, the Ghost Kings, and Hard-Headed Boys. Not to mention strummer for the good old shit. That's us. Hold on, I got to kick myself in the head one time. Bring it back, bring it back.
Whoa. Where?
Elsa Brandy, San Pablo Dam Road, Rancho Bar. It's between 11:30 and 4 o'clock. And that's the third week of September, 21st. Should be a Sunday.
That's the Ghost Kings and Blind Illusion. With the hard-headed boys and some good old shit. All day, Dam Road, Elsa Brandy Street. The babble and into the bubble of the demon's trouble, yeah. That's the babble and into the bubble of the demon's trouble.
Spaceships. Spacemen drink beer? Do spacemen smoke? So the space comes back and the spaceship is parked where he left his car, right? He's parked. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? Where'd the spaceman go? He went to the cleaner. Everybody knows the spacemen have to go to the cleaner. So he comes back, his spaceship's sitting there. He gets in the spaceship, he's got all these tickets. He's got all these tickets to, you know, from parking. But does the spaceship have turn signals? You know, maybe spaceships are invisible. Maybe they're from a different dimension. Yep.
Not doing anything crazy, though.
Is that like a beard or something?
No. So acts as an arm when he gets beaten in the head with paper balls like this.
It's our latest victim. Yeah. Look at that shit.
Imagine that. Let me see.
Get thee behind me, cosmic booger! Get thee behind me, cosmic booger! Get thee behind me, cosmic booger!
Folks, this show has been sold out. I have to ask you to leave or heavily armed. You see, security guards will come wrestle you to the ground. Force you to buy a ticket to the next show. No, stay around. We do have some seats left. We encourage everybody on campus today. Drop out now. Take your books, drop them on the ground, give it up, come back another time. Try to stretch your school career out for 20 or 30 years. It took me about 20 years to get out of undergrad school, and it's taken me 10 years to think about grad school. Still thinking about it. When I know for sure, I let them know. Do you ever see these students the first time they get here? Like they're freshmen. First time to study French. Then I'm going to travel to Europe for a little bit, then get to know my family. Then I'm going to study. Then by the time the grad students are gone.
No.
What are you studying?
Rebecca.
Where do you live? What are you doing this weekend? I'm going to study. We're going to take the rose garden and put weed in there instead. Got this guy coming over already. I'll be there. Who do you want me to talk to? The Jews, the Palestinians. We can get some people together. Nobody wants to stand out in the middle of a bunch of roses and have a war. Get them together, a little stone, some Marley music. We got the Constitution in my back pocket. It's right where the Republicans keep it. Right close to their ass. Wipe it with it. Oh, look, I got some habeas corpus on there. Oh, look. Oh, look, I get some free speech. Oh, it's gone. It's Constitution, man, if you were to, like, reprint it now, it'd be like three sentences. Shut the fuck up. Get in jail. Oh, kids. And we're thinking about Berkeley. It's a beautiful place to be. People are speaking out against the corporate enemy. Like we talked about our teachers that are nice. Nice to see you outside, Professor. Did you grade anybody today?
No, yesterday.
Yesterday? You better go down to Larry Blake's and have a drink. That's tough ass work making fucking UFO symbols on papers. Your whole life. Good God, they pay these people too. Did you ever see these professors? They have these like patches on their elbows. You know how they get those? To get tenure, they will crawl on the ground to the chancellor's house and kiss his ass. Sir, you look too happy to be at Cal. Thinking of transferring? Whole thing is a scam. I've been here 30 years. I'm the only one who's still unemployed and broke. Do you notice there's no wildlife on this campus except crows? Like this is some giant Dracula's castle. No, excuse me, there's only three kinds of seagulls, squirrels, and crows. All other wildlife has been eliminated. And the other day I actually saw gang warfare over a piece of pizza between some gulls and squirrels. You know, the squirrels go, fuck you, asshole, get your fucking white ass out to the ocean. You know, and the seagulls are going, well, fuck you, and we're coming in. Fucking shit's sitting there, you ain't doing it. But I don't trust the squirrels, see, because many times I sit around on a bench, they're talking about politics, you know, I say something about the war. All of a sudden the little squirrel hops up. Yeah, look at the eyeballs. Those are cameras. These are automatronic little fucking midgets coming at. Yeah, they always come up. What are you talking about? Get the fuck out of here. How about this little creek down here? No damn life in it. The only thing in there is these little bugs get on their legs going, oh shit! I remember one time I was up stream a little bit, smoking a joint one time, out of this pipe came this white shit. Straight from the labs. I mean, get your little testing thing and find out what's in there. Tritium. You know, when they first started developing plutonium and nuclear weapons out here, studies, that's something they use. Never could get rid of it. Still in the creeks. Hey, what are you studying today? Oh, is that your mom? I'll get that meat from you later. How you doing? Come here. Hey, sir, no, just 1 minute. Are you a student here?
I'm a postdoc.
You're a postdoc? What's your name?
Hajing.
This is Hajing. You're a postdoc in what?
In physics.
Postdoc in physics. You're the student of the day! Hey, that's it, dude. You're through. Laughs he'll get in 4 years.
Oh my goodness. That's right. I act even more foolish when I have a camera on me. Or you should see me at normal. I'm kind of. What?
Down.
Name my son Whiskey.
Try to be realistic.
Does he do that to other people?
He does that to everybody. For the movie.
Check it out again?
Yeah.
All right, there's
wow, what's it say?
Big fat Berkeley homeless movie.
Right on, thanks.
And another big fat Berkeley homeless movie.
Wow. Dude. You got it wrong both times.
Excuse me, sir.
I'm helping, sir.
How long you been in business here?
Too long. Sunshine, don't come in the moonlight. Don't come in the sunshine. Don't come in the
was good.
Bring it down for him, man.
Berkeley will lead volume 1 and volume 2. You might imagine something like this would go for a whole gang of money, but it's actually quite reasonably priced. No money down, easy payments. Can I follow you home? Can I use your telephone? Can I stay with you just for a few days? Can I sit in your lap? Can I give you the clap? We're from Rolling Stone, so it's okay. Can I stay with you just a few days?
No.
Can I ride in your car? Can I play your guitar? We're from Rolling Stone, so it's okay. Can we stay with you just a few days? You're someone I've seen, you know what I mean. Did they say that you look like James Dean? Can I ride in your car? Can I play your guitar? Can I stay with you just a few days? I'm told that's on Leon Russell's Carney album. In any case, folks, have you picked out all your stocking stuffers for this season? May I personally recommend my Big Fat Homeless Berkeley movie and another Big Fat Homeless Berkeley movie. You might say volumes 1 and 2. Here we have 2 movies for the low, low introductory price, no money down, of $10.
Something happened.
And what were you going to do with that $10 bill besides wrap it around the beer can so your hands won't get wet? With enough of, you can take an awful lot of $10 bills to make the short leg on a table even out to the 3 that are the right leg. Yes, next week, helpful handy household hints for what you can do with those extra hundreds.
You see that penny? Now just watch, now just listen so you learn something.
Yes.
You see that penny? I'm gonna turn that penny into 50 cents, 2 quarters. I'm gonna make that one little brown penny turn into 2 quarters. You ready?
Yeah, yeah.
Look, I have nothing in this hand. Ready? Watch.
How did you do that?
It's magic.
Oh my God.
Are you a cop?
No, no control, I'd unlock my mind. I can't take any more of me. 9 years old and my mind's so cold, I can't barely hold on to myself.
With a B-29, with a load of a goose egg, a duck egg, and a screaming eagle egg, okay? And then landing in Sandbag International Airport, okay? And we are gonna get the cream of the milk, okay? Right out of the curds, man. You know, and there isn't gonna be any ifs, buts, or maybes. Everybody's gonna get a slice of the cheese, man. You know? And that's it, man. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, we're working on part 3. I forgot about that.
Yep.
Well, you know, the real thing I actually believe is that I actually believe the real thing. That's really what I believe, actually. That's really good. I like this.
Happy weekends.
Load the pipe. Get the superstar stoned.
Light.
All right, and then film it and make money off of it. You know, I mean, this guy knows how to do things around here.
What are you doing coming up to me, Johnny? What the fuck do you think you can come up directly to me, dude?
You can't fucking come up directly to me when I first wake up. What? You talk to my maid service first. Don't you ever come up to me before I've had my coffee. Johnny, don't ever come directly to me. Come to me through the maid service. Cut it out, Johnny. Cut it out. Cut it out, Johnny. Johnny, did I tell you? How many times did I tell you not to come directly to me? You need to fill out an application first at the front desk, and you need to sign in. Don't ever come directly to me. Okay, Johnny, slap 20 over there, and I'll put it over here in that dumpster, okay? All right, have a nice day. Bye. Don't you play with me, Johnny. Johnny, don't you play with me, man. Johnny! Johnny! Johnny, don't play with me! You're not a cop, are you? Are you a fucking cop, Johnny? Are you a fucking cop? Don't ever come directly to me. I'll give it to you this time, but don't ever fucking come directly to me again, okay? You fucking fill out an application at the front desk. And you fill in a timesheet form and you sign in, okay? And you get a number. Don't ever come directly to me.
Good morning, America. We're here. Justice has been served.
Yeah.
The unjust arresting of me, Dan, Sadiq, for the trying to defend some trees for what they considered ecotism. 8 months now, my laptop, all my belongings, notebooks, clothes, getting it back this morning. Today's what, the 28th or 29th? Or 28th? Yeah. Look at that. Computer back, everything's back. Yeah, that's my dad.
Does he know you're in my movie?
No. He doesn't need to see the movie.
What?
He doesn't need to see the movie.
Do they?
At home, right now with my eye cam, it's the central force in the newest technology. Everything I look at, everything I see, you can now program on your iPod phone. So in other words, whatever I say becomes reality in your head. Planted in your head, in your eyeglasses if you'd like, stereo. Ear implants and eye implants. Can you imagine? It's here, it's a new technology. And I'm here to tell you about it. Talking to my coffee.
Who are you? Why are you filming us?
Nice to meet you.
Just have an entire movie that's just my face for hours doing nothing but this.
You fucking gotta be kidding me, dude. I just fucking put my whole life into it. Your fucking cause, man. No, I'm fucking not. Look. Are you a cop? Here. Just take it, man. Take it. Take it to the limit one more time. Take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels make you crazy.
take it, man.
Really. You see, going back.
All right, naked girls.
Really, dude. Really, just take it. Here.
I know.
Here, hang out, Johnny in Berkeley, having a great old time. What time are we talking? Well, give me a call when you get. Give me a call when you get on the bridge. Fuck you. Quit filming me. All right. See ya. You gotta come up with a real motherfucking song.
Paint it black.
Seeing your face colored in a brown and duty black. I see no colors anymore. I want them to turn black.
Dude, your camera's the only good thing going on Telegraph. Are you gonna make a movie?
Oh, shit, here he is.
Are you in trouble?
No, we're gonna be. We're gonna be one of big, fat, homeless, dip Berkeley bird fart videos.
What's it like? Come here. What's it like? Chicken. Chicken poo. Look. It's chicken poo.
Oh, you little fat.
Just like their mother, the youngest one with curls. It's a story of a man named Brady who was busy with three boys of his own. They were four men living all together, yet they were all alone.
Can you sing any louder?
Until one day when the lady met this fellow, and they knew that it was much more than a hunch that this group should somehow form a family. That's the way that we became the Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch, the Brady Bunch. That's the way we became the Brady Bunch. Not the Partridge Family, the Brady Bunch. Man, never done that all the way through. Are you going to, you give somebody your word, Johnny? You don't go buying clothes when you owe somebody money. Come on, Michael's not your father. What are you doing going buying clothes when you owe somebody money? Come on, I'm gonna pay him! I'm gonna pay him! And just for lying, I'm gonna hold this until payday, and Michael come down here and we'll take care of this. You said you've been, he's here. What do you mean? Oh, maybe that's Tuesday before last Tuesday. The week before last Tuesday. Okay? See this $10? This is a good $10. You know, I borrow money from everyone in the neighborhood. So I can't borrow money from anybody. Except for you, because you're a fucking jerk off. And I'll fuck you right where you stand. You know that? You and anyone else.
Jimmy, are you in there?
Yeah, Mama. I'm gonna come and open the door in a minute.
My. What's that smell in there, Jimmy?
The rope dope.
Tell me.
Rope
dope?
Yeah, the rope dope.
Yeah, you know the rope dope. Yeah.
I'm not in the mood.
Alright. Alright. Get the feet work. Get it work. There you go. There you go. Watch this.
Double
up on him. Double up on him.
I was in the ring.
He's skilled, man.
I don't believe you.
I don't feel it, man.
I think you're lying. I think you're telling me something.
They're not fighting any names anymore, Muhammad. Jose Feliciano said he might fight me. Look, Mike Tyson, though.
Mike will fight you. He'll fight anybody.
I'll whoop Raven Reddick right back to Jamaica where he came from. I'll whoop Robin Gibbons and her mother.
In the public, you gotta make sure you got a bottle opener. Matter of fact, I still got a couple of fucking bottles to open. That's what's cool about Mark's backpack. Oh, more cigarettes. Oh, some cigars. Here we go. Can Mark open the beer? Without cutting himself. Okay, cut.
Here is my nose. This is my nose here, okay? This is my kidneys. This is my liver. Let's see. This is my forearm. This is my other arm. This is my leg. And this is my... golly. So confusing. You know how I learned it, though? You know how I figured it out? You want to know how I figured it out? Kidneys. So you got it figured out yet, or no? Still not. And you did all that with that damn thing. You know what you ought to do? You know what you ought to do? Figure it out. You're doing this for your own amusement. Very amusing. Extremely amusing.
Silver horses plan down moonbeams in your dark eyes. What do you think of that?
See, living lonesome, it's just best way to be. I'm by myself and nobody else to say goodbye. Everything is temporary anyway.
How are you doing?
What's up, dude?
I'm alright. How y'all doing?
So I just got his camera back, so let him run around.
For sure.
In case we got anything to say, we're new.
I love the lip ring.
Thank you.
Yeah, how long is it for now?
I don't know. Years.
Years? Wow. I think it gets you, I think it's sexy to see people with, like, a thing going on. It's like a werewolf thing.
Yeah, I guess.
You. Running Wolf, take the $5 bill, you fold it, so the folded edges touch, and you have the World Trade Center. Can you see that, young man? Now, this is on four different bills. This is the first bill. Once again, you have a $10 bill, fold it lengthwise, fold it so the folded edges touch each other, and you get the explosion of the World Trade Center. Remember, this is in sequence. There are four bills, the five, the 10, and the 20. You take the 20 and the 50. You take the 20, folded edges touch each other. This is the World Trade Center smoldering. Two towers. If you think this is a trick, on the backside, there's the whole smoldering hole in the Pentagon. What planes hit the World Trade Center? United.
Which means to threaten the university.
And American.
Do something I want.
It even flies into a plane. Who ordered it? The White House or corporate America?
I mean, I wouldn't have been.
9/11 equals 20, which this maggot broke 20 treaties with my people. And finally, in God we trust. What does that mean? God means guns, oil, and drugs. It's an acronym. And in trust means that you trust that this worthless paper is worth something. Boom. Welcome to America.
Cleaning up the star. They've now spent more money on the athletic center and cleaning the star than they have on the undergraduate education. Fuck the undergraduates. That shit should be cleaned up. Can you see the argument of the regents? But, Mr. Regent, kids don't have books. They can't afford to... Shut the fuck up! That star's got to be fixed! That's a fascist fucking star! You know what it says, don't you? Fiat Lux. Let there be light. I'm not talking about this light. I'm talking about the flash of a nuclear weapon, which they still hold the patents to. Oh, you can hear the folk music in the background. But just remember, why are they always fucking fixing something here? You know, I've been walking up that walk for 30 years. There was one little crack in it. That's where your money goes.
How are you, like, $4?
Where are you going, man?
Oh, I'm going to the...
Thank you.
Mediterranean.
What's going on there?
I'm going to go there and make a few phone calls.
Don't make me edit this.
Oh, it's going to be great.
You know, you could be a part three now too. This is funny.
It's gonna be amazing.
Remember, this all started with me and you over there, me taking photographs.
Yeah.
Years ago.
That was great. I know.
And now it's this.
It's come to this.
Yeah, I'm so happy.
All this time.
I was, yeah.
I'm gonna join an athletic club and get on some steroids so I can come beat your woeful ass.
You don't need that.
Yes. So you can come looking for me, baby. I'm gonna find you.
Thank you.
Destroy. All right, baby. I'm on my way.
Good day.
Good day. Now we go back to
ow!
You, Johnny, are you retarded? Are you making a queer out of being afraid of me or something? Hey, hello, Deborah.
Oh no.
Shirt in a mahjong game. The back door of which I was guarding on a fire escape when these two cops came.
Cops or cocks?
And they hung me from the, and they hung me, and they'll hang you. They'll hang you. Don't try it, they'll hang you.
Wait,
it's
what?
Part three.
Nikki's such a cop.
Come on, man.
That is us.
Welcome back. You're part of history.
You're really funny.
I want
funny.
This video.
You're
I actually
funny.
Want this.
It's gonna be like the ring. They're gonna corrupt you.
Look, I get $10 from you're in
He's
it.
A
you
con
can,
artist.
You can have this one.
You can have this one?
She can have this one. Yeah. She's in it.
I'm in it too.
Wait,
I'm
what
right
is
there.
It?
Well, there you go then. You guys can have one.
Berkeley maybe? What's
I mean, if you're rich and you've got money coming out your ass or something,
it's
I'll us, take five for
no,
you.
No, it's not.
Well, it is now.
Russell, is that us?
Now he's in it. Which is weird.
You're in the third one. And it's playing in the window right over there in Rasputin's.
Really?
You think I'm lying?
That looks like
nope.
Nikki right there.
Look it. There's Pink Cloud. I'm looking at him.
This would make such a funny movie.
Every day you're in the you're
hey,
you play up
hey.
There. You know what your line is?
Is that Nikki in
the weed?
That looks like him.
It is
your line is the weed is fucking amazing. That was it.
That's
that was
all
hilarious.
Said.
It was great.
Wait,
yeah.
when?
Well,
when did I say that? Are you the devil?
No, I'm John. I did something good.
That's not us, dude.
That is okay. us, actually. It's definitely me. I know.
Hey, that's sick.
And that looks like you.
I don't know.
Where?
It's a little, like, different.
I don't know. I think this is a trip.
No.
We should watch it just to check. Because I believe that it is.
I think it's like the ring. We're going to die in, like, 7 days.
Hi. I am the invisible man of you don't see Berkeley. You don't see what I mean, do you?
Just like how I had to put tape on my bicycle to manifest what it is, well, the way in which this hand cart is prepared, brought forth, circulated, it's real. I've got my AA degree in sleeping on more AC transit than most drivers ever drove. I got my BA in San Francisco doing the same thing in Muni. And by the 80s, I had my master's degree in riding the back of Greyhound, a teaching credential in taxi. But somehow I forgot, man. It was decades. I had to go ride the Greyhound from Atlanta to here just to re-up in my master's degree certification. I have to say the seats are softer, the back is less murky, but the baggage handlers, the station agents, and the drivers, shit, you gotta do the job just like you do on AC Transit. You can't depend on the paid talent no more on Greyhound. Okay? Both he and I know a whole shit a lot about finesse, and let me tell you, whichever way you stack it, bet on the mouse. I've seen him land on his feet through some remarkable times.
Yeah, I seen Johnny come up.
I seen Johnny before they saw him. John Shaw is the way I call it, the real police don't need no stinking badges. And the only way you get to know who the real police are is when they get between the child and trouble before the child even knows enough to get alarmed. Well, I saw him come out of character, bust a move, save a child that he didn't know. And to me, that made him the real police. This is long before I knew he could sling a video camera.
Hey, what is this, man? Freak!
You on Canada camera?
Freak! Freak! Freak!
So you didn't feel understand?
Yeah, man! All right, but yeah!
Ken, Rich Chase Ken?
This is the guy that owns fucking Rasputin's, this freak.
I'm sorry, Ken, I didn't mean to cut you off.
And what's this book? Where'd you get a book like this at? Where'd you get a book like this at?
Up there at Asian.
Where can you buy a book like that at?
I don't know.
It says, nothing in this book is true about exactly how things are.
What kind of book is that?
I don't get it, man. This guy likes putting a camera in front of my face, huh? Does that guy have a camera in my face?
Film me, don't film me. But one day, the camera's gonna be pointing at you, Johnny. It's gonna be pointing at you. And you're just gonna be normal for once. I'm still not comfortable with the camera. You know, because you don't do it cool, man. Like I said, give me a little box with psychedelic colors and mirrors and shit so I don't see it. Like, right now, I'm cool over here. But this little part right here, I'm like, eternity is staring at my cock, and Johnny will make it look bad if I don't swing it properly, guys. Crazy people attract to that. You know, they adhere to that. But I think that real life can be captured through this brand new medium of yours. If you grow some balls and decide not to be homeless, takes a couple bucks, a couple friends, you gotta talk to people and not snatch the fucking gold out of their hand once you give it to them. Because then, when you skip out on rent 6 months later, they expected it and you're fucked. You know, you gotta be quick about that shit. You gotta be like, and you fucked up. You know, you can't be like, well, I kind of made it look like I fucked up, so you wouldn't look like you fucked up too bad. No, just be like, you're done fucked up. And then hang around and be like, I won't tell. Not, you know, like, fuck hard. Walk hard. Fuck hard. We're all kids in a goddamn fucking sandbox. And she saw me rubbing up against some other kid in the sandbox and threw the Tonka truck at my head. That needs to be immortalized. Cut, print, tape, rap. You're too respectful, let's put it that way, to all involved. They're all fuckers. And you view it as like some Kabbalah, like some coda of like God offered you shenane at the parking lot and she'll keep your fucking rooster safe as long as your fucking 12 chickens. Like, get the fuck out of this voodoo game, man. Like, this is not normal life. That's all I have to say. Like, I'm not a normal person, and I can seriously sit here in your chateau and go, 2 years have gone by, Johnny, this ain't normal anymore. You know, it was normal before. It was cool. You were in their face. You made on East Bay Express. You were filming them, and they were freaked out, and they don't know what the fuck. But nowadays, come on. It's just natural progression. We're getting old. And they're like, sure, Johnny, you can stay at my stand. Sure, Johnny, you can leave your fucking thing in my house. Sure, Jesse, you can work here. Sure, Jesse, you know, this girl hit on you even though you have a girlfriend. This is boring. Boring dynamics. Weren't you at least challenged in Santa Cruz? Didn't you feel challenged? I felt challenged. It was so hard to love those fuckers, and I think we pulled it off. You gotta fucking do what I tell you to do every time I tell you to do it. Without money involved. And I don't even know where my ideas will come from, but they'll come. No, I'm teasing. Serious. You gotta get over the goddamn word homeless. It doesn't get us laid or get us accommodations. God damn it. Bullshit. You say the word skateboard, you say the word surfboard, and we're laid and we're pretty, and you're just like, yeah, Jesse, just the way they want us to be. They want us to be fucking laid all the time and fed all the time, those fucks. Well, I think we could get laid all the time and fed all the time and then kick him out from the inside. Remember life? If there was a camera?
Did anyone remember that?
I don't think poo jokes are funny anymore either. It's not from personal experience. But I don't think they're funny. And this would be like my big fat full of poo people Berkeley movie. Fuck them! They chose poo! That's cool for them. It doesn't sell movies. Did you ever figure that out? People don't want it. They don't want to see homeless people. We've always tried to homeless. Think about it. We've always tried to make them house the homeless. They don't do it. They're not going to pay you $10 to watch somebody that they'll let be homeless. I know you're really mad at me for saying this because that was the key word for the past 2 years. Fuck that shit, man. I'm serious. It's in my big fat pussy Berkeley movie and you'd sell 10,000 fucking copies. It'd be the goddamn same movie. And everybody watch it, fast forward, rewind. Where's the pussy? It's the butt. Homeless in the title, not cool. Even my mom, I don't tell her I'm homeless. I'm saying, Mom, you didn't pay my rent this week. But I don't let her know I'm homeless. Okay. It's not cool. Why do you think they're killing us? Because we're homeless. Thank God nobody's wearing, like, fucking
I wanna be artistically expressed.
Thank God we're not walking around with like tents on our backs anymore. At this point, in your artistic career, since you have elevated yourself to like halfway above homeless, you should no longer be homeless. It won't work anymore. Dude, I feel you. You're in a catch 20 fucking two. I feel you. How are you gonna come up with anything? What? Dude, you fucked yourself. The very first day you came out with the goddamn title when I was in jail, you should've fucking wrote me and go, what the fuck should I title this shit? But as soon as you title it and pick that homeless Berkeley movie, well, we're homeless forever now, aren't we? Be an 80-year-old going, you know, I'm sorry. We're homeless, but we have to respect mom and dad, like, we're at home. Maybe I'll get a job again, and I'll make enough money to give you money. And employ you for a day, and you follow me for a day, and you do what I want to do, maybe? Just for one day. See the fuckers I gotta see all day. I gotta see people like you, Johnny.
This is rather gorgeous. Dude, you should blow this spot up. You should bring girls back here nonstop, like, nobody's mad when there's girls involved. Did you get that?
The only way to beat this system is by using half of the system? I'm serious. Nobody agrees with me. But you can't fucking just smack him in the face with something different. And off the record, I'm a stand-up guy. The memory in my mother's brain, you know. That'll get me through most court trials. You know, like, my mom will show up and be like, he's a great kid. And I'll be like, yeah, but Johnny's a weirdo, man. Somebody pissed him off, so I fucking killed him. So don't get too weirded out, Johnny. You have to be angelic, or the rest of us fucking kowtowing followers, because you didn't give us any other roles in your movie. It's all so good at playing the fucking muse, whatever fucker wants it. Johnny Allen Shaw wanted a Jesse Allen Shaw being like, well, we don't really have a movie yet, but if I get drunk, we'll start the show. You made a bunch of money, you motherfucker. You told somebody you sold 800 videos. 800 videos. And I want you to look at that and think of that as $8,000 in your own brain. $8,000. Imagine if you got back to your grassroots when you're actually striving. At the age of 25, you were like, holy shit, ain't nobody gonna care but some crazy Johnny Allen Shaw guy. Oh wait, he don't exist yet. And you just sit there, who gonna look at my shit? And now when you're looking, they ain't providing. Just random sons of bureaucrats who ain't dead yet. We will kill them off. Johnny Allen Shaw, your friends won't be alive 10 months from now, let alone 10 years from now, when we can't kill you off because you're so smart to put a lens in front of your eye cap. What you gonna film, Johnny? All of us, Robotron? Oh yeah, you gonna film that? You gonna film that? Us doing what we're told? Johnny don't like doing what he's told, does he? Oh no, he didn't like those family parent figures now, did he? They got a job and they didn't treat him right. They didn't treat him well. In fact, they tried to shortchange Johnny Allen Shaw for like $2. $2! Who the fuck cares that I will pay you? I don't know you. $2. I'm sorry. I know you. I know your pain. Apparently he does himself too. But fucking Johnny, who could give a fuck? And you actually made them give a fuck. Fuck your camera, I'm talking to you. You made them give a fuck, John. I don't know who they are. They're not my friends. They're kind of your acquaintances. But you made them give a fuck. You made them give a fuck. And I kid you not, I've known you since the day we first met, and I would not give away my fuck for the bullshit we have. Wait. I take that back. I would not give away the last 3 fucks that I have had for the times we have. You get it all. You get it all. I'm serious. Fuck this shit. You understand? I ain't trying to be camera worthy. I'm talking to you. There's a soul in there. There's a Johnny Allen Shaw. And he's like, I'm almost a Shivite. I'm between red and yellow. Red and yellow. And they're all like, it rhymes with iron. Your fucking camera like puts us all in eternity's grasp. Why don't you fucking sneak the shit in? You know, next time you see me, it'll be sneaky TV and I'll be like Mitch Mitchell going, I don't even know you're there. No. But at least I'm being real. When the camera's in my face, I'm like, oh, am I on Bart? Oh, I'm grabbing girls' asses. Oh, my godmom's watching. Holy shit. I ain't coming home for Christmas, godmom, if you don't buy me some commissary. Do you get it now? It's a commissary regime. And if you don't get your family members to pay the extra 79 cents tax, ain't nobody going home for graduation this year. No more. That's all I got. No, wait! Wait, I got lots to say! I got lots to say!
I just quit for 3 months. I got a lot of clout. I got a lot of prestige. All my drinking friends don't like me anymore, Johnny. I'm not the same person I once was.
Because, I kind of took after you. I hope you put this in your film next to Alan going, I'm selling this movie
because of you. I decided to be Charlie Bronson going after Henry Fonda because of you, Johnny Allen Shaw.
Berkeley, America. Well, I'm in California. I'll get away with whatever I want. I can film all the cowboys.
I'm supposed to wait here for an hour, dude.
For the orange lady.
We're supposed
to go. Yeah, it's called all of Santa Cruz.
We're supposed to go in
all
there
of Santa Cruz. We're all waiting for the orange lady. Hey, look, there's a Krishna temple nearby. There's always got to be in California. Stop filming me. I need to do this for myself. I'm serious, this is important. This is for my own personal development.
I know, man.
No, 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 no. Do you remember that guy? The guy. He was like, I can't do it.
I really can't do it.
I have no idea how Mitch Mitchell convinced me through like 4 syllables to be such an esoteric criminal like I will always admit to being. Didn't we not get enthralled when we entranced? You know, we were entertained. We're at least entertained, Johnny. The effort is shown through more than just the revealing and sacrifice. Revealing, sacrifice, and then what? Oh, hush, hush. We can't tell you. You've got the revelation. You've got the sacrifice. Can you come up with another Freemason? Wait. Rock, paper, my mother's gonna be so mad at you, Johnny Allen Shaw.
Come on, let's go get guru'd. Let's go get it.
Let's go get guru'd. Look, she's taking our lead. She's sipping coffee going, where do we go next? Might as well do too. But if we sit like normal people and eat at the Chinese restaurant, and kips like we're supposed to, then we can be old people and live out our seniority too. Let's grow old together, Johnny. Me and you, man. We only have like 3 or 4 more homeless Berkeley movies. But 3 or 4 more, but we got old and we're like, yeah.
I kind of wish I was Levon the way I filmed him. You know, Levon shows up, and we all wish we were Levon. And we all make fun of him because, you know, he's a Santa Cruz addict, you know. He just likes to walk around with his beach and his staff. And that's the truth. Why do we not follow that truth? There's no reason to not be filming on the coast of everywhere in the Pacific before what? It falls into the ocean? Oh, earthquakes are so scary, but nobody cares until our home beaches fall into the ocean, so you might as well film what's gonna be gone. Go film modern day Atlantis, dog. I haven't been there. That's why I'm a preaching psycho, like, oh, I made it as far as the Krishna temple, but I really like the $2 beer in town. Onward, onward, onward.
She knows my pain.
I can't drink it here. I have to go to the beach to drink it.
Stop filming me! I have to get drunk! I have to go get drunk!
If you put this in my movie, I will make a movie about your like third cousins thrice removed, like 20 generations from now. You'll have no idea. But I got a fucking flux capacitor. And I'm gonna make that shit happen like yesterday. Alright?
you make fun of me in one more Big Fat Homeless Berkeley movie, I'm going to be here for the rest of my life. So make a decision, Johnny. Make a decision. Oh my God, Johnny wants me here. You don't have no rights to rhyme or reason over any more decision making. You don't get any more decisions. No longer. You are the DP, okay? You're the cinematographer. You're the guy behind the fucking camera being told what to do. So film me. Now film whatever comes next. Oh no, wait. I'm over here now. I'm not in that direction, Johnny. I am not in that direction. You know what entertainment she has evoking? We need to have an interview with her right now. This piece is over. This piece is over. This piece is over. This piece is over. I'm going insane. This piece is over. Johnny, I will sleep well at night knowing that this piece is already over and you will not cut the camera. Cut camera now. Cut the camera now. I'm not acting anymore. I am not acting anymore.